Hi everyone, today we want to talk to you about indexed universal life insurance. What is it? How does it work? Who would benefit from this type of policy? The steps you need to take if you want to purchase this policy and why we might recommend this type of policy. We are Shannon and Michael and we're with Healthcare Genius. Let's start with what is an indexed universal life policy. Michael, do you want to give us a quick overview?
Yeah, Shannon. So indexed universal life is a policy that has both a death benefit and a cash building component to it. So it's not just about buying a death benefit for insurance like we talk about with term insurance. It does have a cash building, and you can actually increase that cash value building by lowering the death benefit, and there are certain rules around that. But these policies work really well for people who are looking to have both death benefit and to accumulate cash in the policy. Now, it is different than other policies like whole life and universal life in that it allows you to participate in an index, and typically those are stock indexes like the S&P 500, and we'll go into that in a minute, how that works, but they're policies that can really help people accumulate money in a life insurance policy.
So the next question I wanna ask is, how does it work? So if the index is performing well, what does that mean for someone that owns an indexed universal life insurance policy? If the stock market is crashing, what does that mean? Do you lose a ton of the value in the policy, or how does that kind of connect?
So there's a number of different parts to a policy. There is the mortality cost of a policy, and when your agent runs an illustration for you, the illustration will show you what the cost of mortality, that's the actual cost for the death benefit, and this can move up or down. There are guarantees in these policies, but there is a moving scale that the insurance company can charge for mortality.
Does that mean that for as long as you own the policy, the death benefit amount can go up and down? Or do you always know that any day that you should pass away while that policy is in place, you get a certain amount of money?
Great point, Shannon. No, when we're talking about this chart, this only affects the cash value component. So the insurance company, if something happened like back in the 70s and 80s with the AIDS epidemic, we saw insurance companies change the cost of insurance because they were afraid, you know, that would become a pandemic. So these policies do have the ability to charge more for the death benefit, but there's always a guarantee. And so when you see that illustration, you'll see that guarantee. So it doesn't really impact the death benefit necessarily. It just impacts how much cash value you're gonna have. And so then you also have administrative charges that are part of that contract. So that's the insurance company charges, as well as commissions are built into those charges. And then finally, you're gonna have a crediting rate, which is gonna be based on whichever index you choose. And so that's gonna be variable depending on what happens. Now, again, these policies do have guaranteed returns that they'll have. They tend to be fairly low, but there is a guarantee built into most of them as well.
That's good. So you're saying if the index is performing well, there's a lot of upside, but if it's really tanking, you're kind of insulated from that.
That's exactly right. And you know, a good example of this year in 2020 is with the market declining by 20%, 25% in some cases, in a policy like this, you're not going to see that kind of a decline in most cases.
Okay, great. So the next question I have for you is, who really would benefit from this type of policy? What type of person should consider this?
So we look at this, really anybody is a candidate for an indexed universal life policy. We like to use this with people over the long run to fund for healthcare costs when they retire, but also protect themselves while they're working, as well as having access to the cash value while they're working. So again, we've had lots of clients get laid off who have these policies, and they're able to access some of that cash value to be able to pay bills, expenses, should they need it. And in another video, we'll talk about that specific, how you take loans out of these policies and why they can be very attractive versus taking loans out of a 401k.
Yeah, for sure. And I know this type of policy in particular is pretty versatile in terms of who needs it. My husband and I, we're young, healthy. We do know, however, that by the time we retire, we are going to have healthcare costs in retirement, you know, between Medicare costs, between Medicare means testing, and what Medicare doesn't cover, we know those costs are going to be significant. So that's why we have the policy. But if something should happen where one of us passes away before we actually get to that retirement age, then you still do have the death benefit. So we like that, the idea of having multiple uses, of having that upside of being tied to an index, but also knowing that there's a certain amount of money that will be there no matter what for us. So that guarantee is really important. And then there are people that are 30 years older than us that decide that this is a policy that's good for them as well. So yeah, it's pretty versatile. So the next question that I have for you, Michael, is if you are interested in this type of policy, what are the steps that you need to take in order to get one?
Yeah, Shannon, this is something we always try to remind people. There's a misconception out, even among a lot of pretty popular financial advisors in the media, we won't mention any names, but that insurance, that you can always qualify for an insurance policy. That isn't necessarily the case. I think I was reading yesterday that the Centers for Disease Control estimate that 6 in 10 Americans have a chronic disease, which can be, heart disease, diabetes, cancer, things like that. So when you look at the steps, first of all, the insurance company is going to ask you to fill out a questionnaire. It's going to ask all sorts of questions about, your demographic information, name, age, social security number. It's also going to ask you about your health conditions. So, have you had any serious illnesses? Sometimes they'll require an exam where you have to have a doctor come out. Sometimes they don't. Sometimes they require blood and urine. And these are normally based on how much insurance you're looking to buy. So if you're going to buy $1 million or more, a lot of companies require that you have a blood and urine sample taken. They also look at your prescription drug usage, which they can actually verify through different systems out there. So, those are the first steps you have to go through from the standpoint of qualifying for coverage. And the insurance company, once they've done all of that, they're going to give you their results, which sometimes it could be a decline. In most cases, that doesn't happen. Or they'll give you a rating. It could be standard, it could be preferred, it could be preferred plus. So those are all going to be based on what happens once they've looked at you and looked at your health history.
So your premium is really going to be dependent on all of these things. So if you're in good health, and you get through the underwriting process pretty easily, it's probably a good time to consider one of these policies.
Yeah, Shannon, and then the other step, so once you've been underwritten, then really it's time to try to determine, your agent will look at, how much death benefit do you need? What's the real purpose? If you're trying to max out death benefit, then that's gonna be different than if you're really trying to max out the cash value of the policy. We typically are looking for most clients and maxing out the cash value. So we want to make these less dependent on the death benefit and more dependent on what the cash value is going to be, specifically in retirement for most people.
Yep, because we're using this as a tool to help cover those healthcare costs during retirement. So the last thing we want to talk about, which I think is a really great topic for this type of policy specifically, is why we recommend these types of policies, why IULs or indexed universal life policies tend to be a good option.
We've been really looking at healthcare costs for the last 10 to 15 years in our practice. And part of that is that most people are concerned about it. It's one of the top concerns that are recognized every year when people are asked at their workplace what their top concerns are, and healthcare costs and retirement are typically 1, 2, or 3. But the other thing is most people don't understand what those costs are gonna be. So we like these products for people to be putting money away into them so that when they retire, they're able to start taking distributions from the product to pay for their healthcare costs. And what makes them really special are a couple of things. Number one, during the time that you've been putting money into them, you've still had returns that are based on a market index. So rather than a fixed savings account, you're going to have the ability to potentially have a higher rate of return. So that's one. Secondly, if the market goes down, these policies aren't going to go down with the market, whereas other policies in your mutual funds will if the market goes down in most cases. So that's another thing. And then third, and probably the biggest thing that happens, is that when you start taking distributions from these policies, you can do those in the way of loans. And a lot of policies are very favorable in their loan policies, so that you can accumulate the cash in the policy, to start taking it out, and have that last for quite a bit of time, depending on, again, the product and what you put into it. So, you know, those are really the three big things that we look at when we're looking at these products to pay for healthcare costs, specifically in retirement. And then I guess the fourth one is that some of the policies have living benefits as part of the policy. If you got really sick, you could access part of the death benefit over and above what the cash value is to be able to pay for those healthcare costs.
Absolutely. These are great policies. There's a lot of flexibility, a lot of different ways that you can use them, and they're a great planning tool in our opinion. So thanks for watching. If you have any questions, please feel free to let us know in the comments below. If you haven't already, subscribe to our channel so you know when we come out with new videos. If you click the little notification bell, you'll get an email when we come out with new videos. And again, we're Shannon and Michael. We're with Healthcare Genius, and we are here to help.